We're live! Hey, it worked, I think. If it worked, let me know. Can you see and hear me? We're testing out my channel for another live stream because, yes, why not? Let's do it. So welcome along to my own channel. Blimey, this is two lives in a month. We should do this more often. Hello, if you're joining me. I saw a few people joining me and then it all got a bit complicated. So hello, wherever you're watching from. If you're watching the recording, hello recording people. I always like to say hello to you guys. Hello, leave me a comment. Say hello in the comments. So we're gonna be doing some stuff. We're gonna have a chat. We're gonna do some sensor cleaning. If you've got some questions, this is a perfect time to answer them because this is quite a chilled live stream. But I've got a few people to assist me that actually you can see them and hear them, some of them. So I've got Sam on the Super Switcher.
Hello, everybody. Oh no, don't look at us, no.
There they are. And Freya is doing, oh, so Freya's on the Super Switcher, Sam's on the chat. Let's get it right. Yeah, you haven't got a microphone yet, Freya, have you? No, next time. But you do have a giant camera for your face. Look, you can look through that viewfinder. Look, there it is. Yeah, unusual camera positions for today's live stream. Anyway, how are we doing, Sam? Are we all right?
Yeah, we got lots of people watching. Yeah. Shall I let you know whether, well, not everybody, obviously.
Please do.
Yeah, so we've got, Chuck was first in the house. He's from Wisconsin and he's let me know how to pronounce the place that he lives in, but I'm still not gonna say it. we've got Sweden, we've got Germany, South Africa, Paris, Bruce is in Paris, and Scotland, Canada, yeah, we've got loads, Norway, Adele's here, he said, all good from Dagenham, Sir Gavin.
Oh, Dagenham, nice. Hey, yeah. Hey, we're really,
no, I was thinking Sir Gavin, and you're just thinking,
I'm just thinking Dagenham, yeah. I'm thinking Ford, yeah, anyway, fantastic, thank you very much for joining me on this, right, let's get going, because we've got to, a few bits to get through. So I'm going to be cleaning my camera's sensor. I mean, it's not something I do regularly because I tend to find modern cameras are pretty good at self-cleaning, but occasionally it gets kind of worse. So I'm going to start by showing you the problem, then hopefully fixing it. I'll be honest, I've got no idea whether I'm going to fix this or not. I've got my sensor cleaning stuff. You can't, I've got bits and pieces here that we'll get through in a bit. So get that out of the way because that's kind of sticking up. So there's some stuff to get through, but I've no idea whether I'll successfully clean this. And I'm going to say right off from the bat, if you are thinking of having a go at this and you're not confident in what you're doing, don't do it. Get somebody else to clean it, ideally the camera manufacturer or a camera specialist. But you've got nothing to lose. It's not that hard, really. We worry that sensors are easy to damage. They're not. They're pretty robust, as I'm about to prove, I think. So let's take a test photo. Let me show you the problem. I could have pulled up some photos with the problem in, but the easiest way to see it is to actually get yourself a lens and a camera and photograph something white, like the surface of this table is absolutely great. If not, just make a white image on your computer and photograph that. That will work too. There's a few things you need to do to really see the dust. You see it most on wide angle pictures and with small aperture pictures. So to check how badly dusty and dirty your sensor is, I'm going to use a wide-ish angle lens and I'm going to dial in aperture priority mode, f22. Now what I don't want to do is actually photograph anything real. I want it to be just a blurry mess of nothing, because the sensor dust will stay still and then everything else will blur out. You'll see it much clearer this way, because normally you see sensor dust on blue skies, or if you're doing video, anytime you're doing video, it's just so annoying. So what I'm gonna do is I'm in aperture priority mode, I'm in manual focus, and I'm gonna change my focus to infinity or thereabouts, and I'm just gonna wave this around off my ISO. I'm just gonna put my ISO down as well to native ISO. That's better. And I can hear the click. It's kind of like click, click. And that's what I want. I want about a second exposure. This is not a scientific experiment whatsoever, but what it should do is, woohoo, I've already spotted what you were about to see. Yeah, go on, Frey, let's throw up my laptop. So I took a test photo just to make sure we're connected, and then I've just taken three images. Let's go with the first one, because I think probably that's the clearest. So here is what I'm seeing. Okay. I don't know, can anyone spot any dust on my sensor?
No.
I mean, anyone see anything? Any problems there? Oh, it's not the worst I've ever seen. It's not great. There's a bit down here I'm not happy with. There's these two huge dust spots up here, and then there's lots of little ones. There's a theory in the photography community that if you're checking for dust, what you should now do is really increase the exposure and the contrast and or the exposure down. You should really kind of, you know, take all these settings up and then go, oh my God, look at the state of my sensor. This is horrendous. But here's my theory of this. This isn't normal editing. If you have to edit your images that hard and that far, then yeah, you're gonna notice sensor dust. But be realistic. When you're reviewing your images, don't go looking for a problem until the problem is there. I mean, if you're a videographer, go looking for the problem, because by the time you've spotted it, you've just ruined an entire clip. Trust me, it's a nightmare for video. With photography, if you get a bit of a dust spot, you can generally live around it for one photo shoot and then fix it. Oh yeah, I forgot, I'm live and there might be questions.
There's not many questions, just comments. Ken said, more like fingerprints.
They do, don't they?
Biggie Z said, nah, perfectly fine, mate.
Hey, Biggie's in the house. Woo.
And Dell said, filth.
And Dell as well. Oh, well, we got all the boys in. It's fantastic. So, yeah, and it's not bad. Sometimes you get like hairs and dust and you can see real shapes coming through. So this one is definitely in need of a clean. So I think that's what we're going to do next. So once you've established you've got a problem, now you need to start thinking about, how am I going to fix this problem? Can I live with this problem? Am I going to fix it? So there's a few options from here on in, and they get progressively more risky, if that's a word you want to use, because the easiest one, turn your camera off, boing, turn your camera back on again. Now, most modern cameras, particularly the mirrorless type, have like a vibration thing that when you turn your camera on and off, it shakes the sensor. And if you're looking at your image and you see hairs, that might shift the hairs off of your sensor. So just switch it on and off a couple of times. You might even have in your camera menu an option to actually vibrate the sensor, to do a proper sensor cleaning regime where it shakes it really, really fast. My camera doesn't. At least I don't think it does. And if it did, it wouldn't make any difference, because the problem I've got is not surface dust. It's something that needs a bit more of a fix. But that's worth a try, isn't it? Did it fix the problem? I'm not going to test because I know it didn't. So that's thing number one. Okay, then if that doesn't work, I've now got to up my kind of level a little bit, and I'm going to have to take the lens off and start working inside the camera. So let's turn the camera off. We'll unplug the USB so everything is unplugged. So I've got a whole range of things to play with. I've got this, I've got that, and I've got, okay. Right, can we go for a desk shot, Frey? We've got a, there you are. Oh, it's quite close, isn't it? Yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, but that's all right. I can work with that. I set these cameras up myself to blame and nobody else. All right, okay, so hang on, hold that thought. I'm just gonna zoom out a little bit. Here we go. Oh, wrong way. How about, how's that? That's better, isn't it? That's probably easier. All right, in the comments, which would you go for first? I've got a little brush thing. I've got a blower. I've got a cloth. I've got a torch. Actually, that's not for cleaning, that's for viewing. And I've got some little alcohol wipes. Are they alcohol? That kind of thing. Okay, what would you, yeah. So first of all, I don't think anybody is gonna say lens cloth first, but actually, that's really where I'm gonna start. I'm just gonna make sure I'm gonna clean.
You wanna hear?
All around the edge, yeah, you go for it, I'm cleaning, you go.
So, air blower, and blower, and the blower first, blower, ball blower, less touching the better. Rocket blower. Yeah, there's a bit of love there.
There's a bit of love for the blower. I think that's probably about right. Okay, so that's exactly what I would do next as well. So my next thing to try is definitely going to be the air blower. So let's see, how are we going to do this? Whoop, I can do this. Whoa, look at this, so many cameras. It's exciting, isn't it? We're going to undo that, take that off. Yep, there we are. That is the inside of my camera. I don't know if I can get my head down there. Hello, does that work? Can anyone see me? Just to give you an idea of scale, it's small. Put my glasses on. So the torch is here. If you don't have a massive sort of studio lighting system, oh, not that one. Or the SOS, there we go. The torch is here. Go for the overhead view again, Frank. Let's see if we can, okay, there we go. So I can actually see inside of my sensor. Sometimes you can actually see the dust. I can actually see dust on that sensor just by doing this. You can't quite see on that view but we get the idea. So a torch is a useful little thing for just having a quick little look and seeing what's in there. Yeah, Sam, far away.
Dell said, I always use the Arctic Butterfly myself.
Well, like this one. Can't reach Dell. There we go, yeah, that one. We'll get to that, Dell.
And then Patty said you can use the air blower around the lens too.
Yeah. We do.
And then Jean-Francois said there is, in his camera, there's a feature called cleaning. Do you think it's the shaking that you're talking about or something else?
Now, that's a really good question, Jean-Francois. So sometimes, it depends on the camera. If it's a mirrorless camera, then it probably is sensor cleaning, it might well be, but when we get to actually touching the sensor, it might be something else. But if it is a DSLR, the ones with the curtains, it's probably, it locks the curtains out the way when you get to the more nitty-gritty stuff. Actually, that's a really bad term, not nitty-gritty, no gritty, just nitty. So it could be either. Obviously, read your manual, Google it, whatever you need to do before you go, oh yeah, I'll just dive in. I mean, who reads a manual? I don't think my camera even comes with a manual. So yeah, clean the mount. Once you've got your lens off, clean the mount, make sure there's no any, I mean, there's never any grease on there, but make sure there's nothing nasty on there. And yeah, I always reach for the blower brush. Always a blower brush, or a blower rather, a blower, and never a can of air. You can get can of air. Back in the day when I used to do slides, you could actually get canned air and blow the dust off the slides. Terrible idea because it left a film on the glass slide mounts that we used back in the 80s and probably the 90s. And it's the same now. You just leave a film of nasty stuff all over your sensor. Of course, it's not actually the sensor. I can't actually get to the sensor. The sensor is below a layer of glass. You know, camera manufacturers aren't dumb enough to put raw electronics directly within your reach. Okay, so I can do this. Give it a good blow all the way around. Ideally, you do it this way up. But it doesn't make for a good video, does it, really?
That's exactly what someone just asked, actually.
Yeah. Ideally, you do it the other way up, so gravity will help. But it doesn't really make a great video. And I already know it's not going to help. But we'll have a go. We'll have a little test, see if it made any difference. Okay, let's test it. Out of interest, has anyone ever done this? Is this something anyone else does? I used to do it all the time with my very first digital cameras because they didn't have any sensor cleaning technology built in. But nowadays, things are changed quite a bit. And cancel changes. Yes, that's it. Hello. Hang on. Plug that in. Nowadays, it's something I've found I have to do an awful lot less. There we go. We're up and running again. I'm just going to tether this in so you can see. One moment.
Yes, you've had quite a few people reply. Ken said yes. Alvin said yes. Ephraim said, I do it occasionally when I see something on the sensor. Jacques, yes, a few times. Michael, no, I haven't, but we're wondering if or when I should do mine. And Jean-Francois, never ever, too scared.
Yeah.
Don't be scared.
I know. It is quite a scary thing. It's like, oh my goodness, sensor cleaning, that must be dangerous. Actually, do you know what? It's a little bit better. Or maybe I just didn't apply the settings again. But it's possibly slightly better, but it hasn't fixed the big issues, which are, you know, there's a nice happy smiley face here, isn't there? You can see eyes and a nose, just me. So we need to try something else. So easy way didn't work. Level two, on to the next level. Was it level three? Level three of cleaning. You've tried the camera's built-in cleaning. You've tried an air blower. Next, you're gonna have to get down and dirty with your sensor. It's time to touch the sensor. Woo! Is it? I really need to get, I need to get some better words. Right, all right, let's take the camera lens off. Put the little lens cap on there. Lovely, there we go. So, how am I gonna do this? There's a few ways I'm gonna do this. The first thing I'm not gonna do is get myself, okay. Oh, Frey, I was on it, I had it. There you go. First thing I'm not gonna do is get my glasses, wrap my cloth around it and start rubbing all over the sensor. Don't do this. Honestly, I've seen people do this. I really, really have. Back in the early days, there was an article. God, I can't remember where I read it, but it was like, get yourself a knife, wrap some kitchen roll around it, and rub it. Oh my God, don't do that. So, don't try and clean the sensor with whatever you have to hand. Do this properly. So, I'm going to use this, which is upside down and back to front. Oh, that's the right way around. Look at that. This is a visible dust. Little brush, patent pending. It is got to be getting close to 15 years old, probably older. And I got this when I had a Canon 20D. This was the cleaning system for my Canon 20D. It is a little brush. If I turn it on, woo, around it goes. Spins around. So these are nylon bristles. You can probably see the bristles are a little bit splayed out and seen better days. They're absolutely fine. What it's not designed to do is to go onto the sensor like this. Okay, this is not what it's designed to do. What it's doing is building up a static charge on the bristles. So when I push this across the sensor, all the dust will magically jump onto this. Okay, I don't know which camera I'm on. Oh, okay, I'm on this one as well. It never works. I mean, it works, but it doesn't. It's never quite, you know, brilliant. So let's get rid of this. Let's just bring this in. Oh, there we go. Okay, so the brush is still going. I haven't stopped it. I never know how long you're supposed to leave it. It's kind of like, should it be a few seconds? Is it now so electrically charged that I'm gonna get a static shock off it? No, of course not, it's absolutely fine. So it is ready to go, and I'm just gonna brush this over my sensor like that. Lovely. And there we are. Done. And then the advice is, put your lens back on. Again, you do that upside down, ideally. The advice is to give this another spin to throw off any dust. But then I don't think that works, because if it's got static, if that makes it static, surely that's just going to make it stick, isn't it? I don't know. There you go. And then stick it away. So that actually is quite a good system for removing stubborn dust particles. Again, that's not what we've got with this one, but we'll have a go. Let's see. Oh yeah, I'm live. Yeah. Ask me a question.
Okay. So James said, do you think a smaller sensor shows up dust more?
That is a good question. From practical experience, no. It's been actually less than my full frame sensor. But in theory, because you use wider angle lenses, I'm on that camera, aren't I? Because you use wider angle lenses, yes, because it's all about depth of field. You will never see any dust if you use a 300mm lens at f2.8 or f4, whatever it is. If you use a long lens and a really wide open aperture, you just never see the dust. If you're a landscape photographer, then you're trying to get everything in focus and you're using a wide angle lens at f16, you'll see dust like there's no tomorrow. And if you're a videographer, you can't remove it from a video. You just can't. So it's bad enough for stills, annoying for video. Yeah, go on, Sam. What have we got?
So Donald asked, Pentax. Oh, sorry. I forgot to say I'm here. Donald asked, my Pentax won't let me go into cleaning mode unless the battery's at full power. Are OM cameras the same?
My camera's at 91%. It will let you do it. I haven't had a thing where it said don't do it. And that's partly down to the type of camera, because if your camera is a DSLR with the mechanical curtains, then it has to physically keep the curtains apart whilst you clean the sensor. My camera, when I turn off the power and I take the lens off, I can see the sensor. So there's not really a power issue as such, but we're gonna come to that shortly when we get to the final bit in a minute where it all gets a little bit kind of up close and personal with the sensor. Let's just see where we're at. Here we go. I'd say it's getting cleaner. I think that's actually not bad. Those two little bits there are still there. We can increase the contrast, decrease the brightness, and it's the dehaze that really shows it up, kind of like, oh, okay, that's okay, yeah, we've still got a few. But as I say, unless you're applying an awful lot of dehaze, you probably wouldn't notice these. I could possibly live with this. I can't, but I could possibly live with it. Just to have a little look, let's just open up the first one again, see how that looked, which was this one. In fact, let's open them both at the same time. Let's do two together. That one and that one, and we'll open those. And so we can have a quick look and see how much progression we've made. That's what we started with. That's what we got. Oh, look at that. Okay, can you see the difference? I don't know if it'll come through on a live stream, but there is dust spots. There's a little bit down in the corner, which is actually at the top because these are reversed in reality, and that's all gone. So we are getting closer and closer to having a clean sensor, but I can still see this one and this one. They just don't stay, they just don't move. Oh, there's one really important tip. Oh my goodness, how did I forget to do this tip? This is perhaps the most important tip I'm going to give you about sensor cleaning. When you're reviewing your images on your screen, make sure that the dust and dirt isn't actually on your screen.
Or also on your lens, because a lot of people are saying, have you cleaned your lens?
Yep, no, I've removed the lens. So these are pictures without the lens in place. So yeah, lens cleaning, that's a whole nother video. But this is just the sensor. There's no lens on the camera when I'm taking these pictures. Oh, there is a lens. I tell a lie. There is a lens on the camera. You can't take a picture without a lens on the camera unless you go into the settings.
We'll rewind that bit.
Yeah, can we edit that out?
Yeah.
You're right. But it's not. Remember, my lens is defocused to infinity, and it's not on the lens. And if you're not sure, try another lens. But anyway, make sure they're not on the screen. So make sure they're not by zooming in a little bit and then getting the hand tool and moving. If the dust moves, oh, we're not on my laptop. There we go. If the dust moves when you move the screen around, it's on your sensor. If the dust stays still, then it's on your screen. I'm not going to tell you how many times I've cloned out dust from pictures, and it's like that my clone tool is not working. Why is my clone tool not working? Hang on. Oh, there we go. Am I the only one who's ever done that? I've got a horrible feeling that I could be literally the only person ever to do that. Right, okay, so we've tried blower brush, we've tried The camera's own cleaning system. We've tried the Arctic butterfly, which was way more successful than I thought it was going to be. So let's try wet cleaning. Wet cleaning your sensor swabs and so on. So this is where things get a little bit more interesting. So let's take that apart. So how are you going to do this? Well, first of all, you're going to need some kind of sensor cleaning kit like this one. I'm not being sponsored by any companies for this, and I'll be honest with you, don't buy these. I mean, not if you've got a Micro Four Thirds. You'll see why in a minute. So I had to clean my kit a couple of weeks ago. I had a really bad dust spot and I had to remove it, and I needed something pretty quick. So these were the quickest I could get from Amazon. I mean, they worked. Let's put it that way, but you'll see. You'll see. So they may be fine for non-Micro Four Thirds, but for Micro Four Thirds, there's a fundamental flaw with this particular brand. So when you buy a wet sensor cleaning kit, you get a few things in the kit. You get some sensor swabs, like that. Make sure you get the right size for your particular camera. That's a general good advice, unless it's this particular one, because they can't measure. As you'll see, and also you'll get some cleaning fluid. Now don't try and cheap out and use your glasses cleaning fluid or something you found in the shed or whatever. You use the right stuff. I guess it's it, you know, that's the idea. So that's what you're gonna get in a sensor cleaning kit. Okay, so how am I gonna do this? Well, what I'm not going to do, I'm not just going to start diving in here and off we go. I'm going to set a few things up in my camera first of all, and I probably should have done this for the last one, but I forgot, because that's what happens when you're live. So let me put my lens back on. Okay, and I'll explain what I'm going to do. So I'm going to go into my camera settings and I'm going to switch off a few features. So I'm going to switch off any image stabilization. Don't want it suddenly moving the sensor whilst I'm cleaning it, because I am going to have to do this with the sensor on. I'll explain why in a little bit. And I'm going to put this into not mechanical shutter. If I take a picture, oh, that's a very long one. But did you hear the click? That's the mechanical shutter. That is a physical shutter going across. Okay, I don't want that to accidentally activate. It's a pretty unlikely day, but there is a chance that I might, you know, press the shutter whilst I'm cleaning my camera. And I don't want the shutter mechanism to come crashing down whilst I'm cleaning the shutter. That would be a bad idea. Great live stream, but bad idea. So I'm going to put this into electronic shutter or silent shutter or whatever your shutter is called, where when you take a photo, no sound. Okay, so it isn't a mechanical thing. So if I do accidentally take a photo, I'm not going to damage the shutter mechanism. I mean, it's never going to happen, but belt and braces and all that. All right, okay. So let's open this up. You'll open this up at the very end. That'll be the last thing you kind of do. But for the purposes of this live stream, I'm going to get everything prepared. So sensor swabs. Sensor swabs come in different sizes. You, of course, only ever use these once. Yep, only once, definitely. There we go. I've never used one more than twice, because, of course, if you use one twice, it will actually destroy your sensor. I presume that's why they tell you not to use them twice. And there's my sensor swab. Yeah, I'm going to just change that camera around. Oh, hang on a second. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, because you're going to want to have a lot closer view up of that. There we go. Maximum zoom on that one. All right, let's have a little close-up view with the... There we go. So this is Micro Four Thirds. This is Micro Four Thirds sensor and sensor swab, and they're supposed to be the same size, except, you'll find out. This is basically, these are too small. They should have made them bigger. They should be roughly the same width as your sensor. That's kind of what you're after. A sensor swab, the width of your sensor. Too small, but hey, there we go. Gonna give the bottle a little shake. There we go. I'm gonna put my glasses on. partly because I don't want to get any in my eye, but mostly you want to see what I'm doing. Don't do this right over the top of your, do I really need to say this? Don't do this right over the top of your sensor. Probably do. All of these things I have done in the past, so it's kind of like, this is not the first time. You might want to just lift the camera up a bit, Frey. Frey has got a PT camera, pan tilt. I'm the zoom. Will it go up any higher? Up, I'm going to be up here somewhere. Okay. This is the important bit. Here we go. Right. So the instructions say put 2 or 3 drops on the sensor swab, which is what I'm going to do. Ideally, you'll put them sort of a little bit of a gap in between the two. The camera won't focus. There, well, there we go. Except don't do it right over the camera. That's exactly what I'm doing. So I'm going to put 1, 2. Ooh, so they give you a huge bottle and you use like 3 drips and 1 on the back. Ooh. Oh boy, stress of that. Okay, so top down camera, let's have a little look. Here we go, sensor cleaning time. So I'm gonna clean my sensor. So that you probably be able to see now my brush is just too small. It doesn't cover the whole sensor. And you're supposed to go across once and then back the other way. Except I can't because these little things are too small. Now, when I do, I don't know if you can see. It's got the jelly. No, it doesn't work. So this, is wobbling around like crazy. I'm doing this so you don't have to. Joys of you using an old camera. So my sensor is a... in-body image stabilization, IBIS sensor. So it's floating on magnets. So I need to make sure that my camera is actually turned on and working, because then when I drag this across, it doesn't move the sensor. 1, 2, and it's probably all dried up now. I did that too slowly for you guys. 1, 2, and you can see, can you see how careful I'm being? Let's go one more for luck. 1, 2. Okay. In an ideal world, I wouldn't have to do that because the sensor swab would be exactly the same size as the sensor. Oh. Hey, real world scenario. These things happen. Okay. So, top tip. Let's go back to it. Yeah, there we go. This. Put somewhere safe with that bit not touching anything. So I'm just going to rest it over here like that in case I need to come back to use it in the next few seconds, because of course you're supposed to get a brand new one every single time, and that's what you do. I know you do. I'm sure you do. Okay, let's plug that back in. Let's turn my camera back on. So, good news, my camera still works. It's a good start. We'll wait patiently for my USB to tether in, which doesn't always work because the USB is a little bit old on this camera. Okay. Oh, I'm on. 1 second. I forgot I got it on the wrong settings. Oh, hello, what's going on? Have I pressed that button? My screen. Oh my goodness. Oh, sorry, microphone. Screen stopped working. There's a button on the back of my camera that switches between the electronic viewfinder and the LCD. And somewhere on that little journey, I managed to press that button. And yeah, that was exciting. Right, here we go. Okie dokie, here we go. This is fantastic. Are you ready? I might have made it worse. Okay, my spots are still there. They're not as bright as there. What is that? What is that? I think it's a shadow, but I'm just going to be... Oh, yeah, it's... I'll tell you what that is in a second. Okay, here we go. That's better. What that was the corner of my laptop. Oh my God, I've ruined it. I've ruined my camera. No. Because I'm waving the camera around, not really looking. I didn't notice. I just caught the corner of my laptop in the edge. So don't panic. Okay, but I need to go again. So this bit is still there. It's still there. So I'm going to go once again. No problemo. Here we go. Get that off. And this time I'm going to do it without talking to you guys. If you've got any questions, feel free to stick them in the comments. Oh, that was a big drop. All or nothing.
So, Joe asked, how do you tell if it's dust and not something else when you see the spots?
Yeah, I mean, dust comes in many forms. You'll get physical dust, like, you know, hair, and you'll see it. It'll be slightly curly, slightly S-shaped. And then you'll get dried on moisture spots. So as you get moisture on your sensor, when you get moisture on your sensor, it'll then dry, and it'll dry as an actual kind of ring. A little bit like when if you've cleaned your car and then it rains and then it dries and you go, oh, and you're like, oh, I've just cleaned the damn car. It's pretty much the same sort of thing. So when you're changing your lens in humid conditions, you'll often get that coming across as a thing. So let's just go, plug into USB.
And Pavel asked, what did you put on the sensor? Is it oil?
Yeah, no, do not put oil on your sensor. Yeah, I mean, if you really don't like your camera and you really want a new one.
What is it, alcohol?
It is whatever that came with the kit. So it's going to be some kind of alcohol type product, but don't go randomly pinching stuff out the garage and going, oh, I'll use isopropanol, that'll be absolutely fine. Use what comes with your kit or buy a specific sensor cleaning stuff. You know, don't muck around with that. That's kind of really important. And this time I have to put it into, what have I put? I have pressed so many buttons doing this whilst talking to you guys.
So a few people have said you're only supposed to do it once when you swipe across.
Will
you
no!
do
it?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Is that for demonstration purposes?
Nope, that's the real world. You're only supposed to do it once. Yep, probably. Definitely. Never ever do it more than once. Hang on a second. What have I switched on? I've switched on something in here that I shouldn't have done. Oh, it's up here. Bracketing. There we go. Let's find a nice clean bit. We'll give this a wave. Oh, am I still in bracketing? Oh, there we go. Right. One moment. Oh, they are not going to shift, are they? I can still see them. They are still there. Let's have a go. Let's go back over there. I mean, everything else is clean. It's just that spot and that spot. I'm going to have one more go. And three is kind of my limit. So we talk about not going over it more than once. The reality is you're probably going to have to go over it twice or three times. It's not the end of the world. What you don't want to do is soak your sensor swab in solution, because then you'll leave big streaky marks across it. Other than that, yeah, I mean, be sensible. Common sense is a big part of this. Last one. Okay, here we go. Last try. If this doesn't shift it, then the stuff I have here today is not going to do the job. And that is possible, and quite likely. Okay. Pop that in there. Clean. Clean. Oh, I may have got a little bit too much on this now. Well, that'd be fun. Show you what happens when you have too much sensor fluid. I'm gonna spin it around so I can actually see what I'm doing as well.
So Joe said, not sure if you said, but make sure your white surface doesn't have any spots on it.
Yeah, that's a good point. It's kind of why I'm gonna let that dry off a second. That's why I'm moving the camera around when I'm taking the picture. Because if you just held it still, you'd photograph, albeit out of focus, whatever is on your desk. If you wave it around and your shutter speed is at a second or more, then anything on your desk is going to come out as a blurry spot. And dust has a real distinctive ring. You can really see it. It's like a physically sharp shape in a blurry world. It's kind of weird. Okay, let's just see how we did. Too much moisture on my sensor. Swap. Fantastic. Oh, that's better. I can see. Yeah, I do not like these swabs. If you can get a swab where it is exactly the same width as your sensor, life's a lot easier. Oh. So that's it. 3. That's my limit. If it doesn't work after this, I will definitely take it to a sensor cleaning place. And it, oh, you're not plugged in. Hang on. And because somebody did say about the back of the lens, I will just clean the lens as well. Little cloth. Belt and braces. Right, okay, so last go. I can tell you already, the dust on this is going to be too tough to shift with the kit I've got. Right, so my settings, I'm going to make sure I really blur it out. I'm going to go for a very low ISO. I've got a 1 second exposure and wiggle. Okay, in it comes. Okay. So there we go. Yeah, I think I've still got a couple of bits. I've got one there I don't like, and I've still got these two here. It's not bad. I mean, compared to where we were, let's go get the original and see where we got to. Okay, so that is where we started. That's where we've ended up. We've managed to make a new one. That's clever. But this is the real world, that happens. But most of them we've got to the point where it's faded away enough that I'm kind of happy. I'd probably give it another go, but for the purposes of live, we're kind of there. Yes, Sam, there's a question.
So JB said, are you going to start uploading regularly?
Hopefully, JB, yeah, that's the plan. That would be good, back on my own little channel occasionally. We're still doing Adorama in 2 weeks' time. We'll be back on Adorama TV, but we hope to do another one in 2 weeks. You have to wait and see what that's going to be on my channel as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, keep going, there's more questions.
Yeah. So Joe asked, how often should you do a cleaning on your sensor or take it into a place to have it clean?
Okay, you should never clean your sensor until it needs cleaning. Okay, just don't do it until you look at a picture and think, ooh, probably should clean my sensor. So if you missed the beginning of this, start by using the camera's own system, then try a blower brush or blower. Then try a anti-static brush. If you have either of these are kind of interchangeable in my opinion. They're pretty good. And then, and only then, try a wet method. But if you're not confident doing that, either go to your local camera store, if you still have one, if you're lucky enough to have one in your town, or contact your camera manufacturer and see if they've got someone they can recommend. Often, trade shows are a great place to go. If the camera brands are there, they'll often have a cleaning service available, which is kind of useful. But make the decision about looking at your pictures. So if we go back to my laptop, I reckon in stills photography, I'd probably not notice this. So let me go back and change my camera settings to something a little bit more. Oh, there we go, that'll do. I'm not sure I can get one. Here we go. I will get this. I'm going to get this. Bear with me and let me show you what I mean. Just trying to get everything blurry out of nice. Okay. I'm going to go back to my camera. So the test pictures, I'm at f22. I never shoot at f22, ever. Like never, ever, ever. So if I'm shooting at f2.8, that's f22. That's f2.8. Have I magically fixed the dust? Has it gone? Did I do something between this picture and this picture that fixed my problem? No, that's just, this one is the real world. This is what I actually do every single day, and I can't see the dust anymore. This one is the test photo to see if there's dust that needs removing. And this is the balance. This is what you need to do when you're looking at dust. You can find it. If you go looking for it, every sensor is going to have this. But in the real world, actual day-to-day photography, if you're not seeing it, for goodness sake, don't worry about it. Okay? So don't worry about cleaning your sensor until you need to clean your sensor. Yeah, go for it.
So JB has said, have you tried the Lightroom trick to see the dust?
Yeah, I have. Yeah. So in Lightroom, there's a little option that allows you to see the dust. And I've tried it. It's fine. I mean, I prefer to use, you know, these and a pair of these. It's kind of like, oh, I can see it. Again, you can find yourself fixing problems that aren't real problems. So if it's a problem, it, you know, fine. If it's a clear blue sky, you're going to possibly see it. If it's a bunch of trees, you're never going to see it. So, you know, you bear these things up. So yeah, it's there, it's a feature, but don't let it get in the way of the photography. If you're into your video, I mean, that's another story. With video, you often find yourself, because you have to work at a slow shutter speed of a 60th or 120th of a second, you're often working at fairly small apertures with fairly wide lenses. And those are the prime conditions for seeing dust. So live streams like this, you don't notice because we're at f3.2. But on outside filming, I always check my sensor before I go and do an outside filming job. And I check it by physically doing a recording of something white. So sensor cleaning absolutely can be done. I've got a sensor which I'm clean. Let's go back to my laptop once more, just in case anyone missed it. I've got a sensor now that I'm happy is free of dust. Right at the beginning, I kind of went in and I did crazy things like dehaze. And there it is. There's one. Look. But then if you really are putting your settings to 38, 40% dehaze, then you're probably doing a different type of photography to me. So I can live with that because my reality is that. Okay, that's kind of where I'm at. So I hope that helps. Yeah, any questions?
Well, Sam, no, just the best comment. JB said, your assistant is wonderful and needs a pay rise.
I mean, yeah. JB, yeah. What I like about that comment is he didn't specify which.
Yeah, that's true, but two assistants. I'm going to add an S to the end. Assistants,
yes,
are wonderful. Yeah.
I agree, yes. And as soon as the government give us that tax rebate, then you're up. It'll be fine. It's coming. I'm told tomorrow is the day.
And also, we've had lots of people saying, only however many likes, because there's quite a few people watching.
Oh yeah, we should do stuff like that, shouldn't we?
Yeah, so please go and smash the like button for us, and we'll come and do more.
According to my phone, over 100 people are watching, which is nuts. Why are you watching? That's mad. I mean, thank you very much, obviously, as well. So hopefully you found that useful. Hopefully that has, if you were thinking that you need to clean your sensor, but you were slightly worried, I didn't break my camera. It still works. It still works. Oh, there we go. Yeah, it's still working. It's still, there's a great picture. It still works. It's really hard to break your camera sensor. Your sensor that you look at is not the sensor because it's underneath layers. These are really complicated things. So if you're sensible and careful, you're going to be okay. But if you're at all worried about it, get someone else to do it. But just wait until you actually need to do it. Because this camera's about 3-4 years old, 3 years old. That's the first time it's had its sensor cleaned like that. Okay, brilliant. So there we are, live stream done. Hopefully you found this useful. If you're watching the recording, thank you for watching the recording all the way through. If you watch me live, amazing. Either way, check out my social media stuff, which totally forgot to put in the video description. So I'm gonna put it, and we don't even have a graphic for it. That's how rubbish we are at this. So check me out at TheGavinHoey on Instagram. Please don't ask me why I ended up with that name. It's just, there it is, TheGavinHoey on Instagram. I'm also available on YouTube, but you probably should know that because, hello. I mean, that makes sense, doesn't it? I think I'm on TikTok. What am I on TikTok?
Same with Instagram.
TheGavinHoey, really? Oh no, how embarrassing. So I'm on TikTok as well. Freya does TikTok. She's like, she waves a phone in my face and says, yep, done, that's TikTok. So I'm on there as well, if that's your thing. We're going to be back in 2 weeks' time, possibly on my own channel in 2 weeks today. We're working on that as an idea. Definitely on Adorama TV, over on Adorama's channel in 2 and a bit weeks, where we're going to be doing some stuff with a model. So come join me for that. Thank you very much to Sam and Freya for doing the behind-the-scenes stuff.
You're welcome. Thanks, everyone, for joining in, all your comments and everything. And we'll see you again soon.
We will indeed. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.